Lesson 3 involves mouse and keyboard interaction. Let's open a website, say Pinterest, and start automation. The first question is, how do we make mouse interaction with this website? Start with the most important button, click. In most cases, we choose button left and select by selector. Timeout is the maximum time allowed for this action. I would like to set 5 seconds. If I want to click this shipping container house, so how could we do that? The first method is right click and select inspect. Select the mouse icon. Then click the element you want to open. Right click the highlighted line and select copy expat. Come back to our software and paste into selector box. Yes, perfect. We develop an extension for you, Element Helper. Technically, it's similar to Inspect, but more intuitive. And you can see that the result is the same. There is another method, which is using coordinate. There is no copy, so you should remember the number. We choose select by coordinate. Keep in mind that coordination is relative. It depends on the window size. Next, we have scroll button. There are two options, but we try coordinate first. In most cases, Y coordinate is enough. Let's try 1000 pixels at the speed of 2. Let's see. The scroll motion is very realistic. Another option is scroll by selector. My target is education category, so I need to copy its expat. If the action exceeds timeout, the next step of automation will start from a red dot on the right side of the button. Let's start automation. The browser scrolls to make sure that the education is in the middle of the screen. Next, keyboard button group. Press key and type text. Let's do experiment on Amazon website. Our target is to type into the search box. So first create type text. Select by expat. And my keyword is t-shirts for men. I guess you are skillful at doing this step. Set the speed 1.5. Close the old automation. And this is the result. Let's apply those techniques on Pinterest.com. Element helper is to copy expat. I would like to NFT collection 2022. The situation is, after we've done the typing, we want to press enter. So here comes the press key button. This can press a single key or a combination of keys on keyboard. Let's find enter button. Close the old automation and start a new one. So that's the end of lesson 3. See you next time in lesson 4.